Hey guys, Tom here again from SynthHacker.com. Following on with the theme of using custom wavetables, today I'm going to show you how I made this mallet-based key sound. So I hope you enjoyed that little demo. I really love this synth. It has kind of a nostalgic character to it, but with a more modern sound, which I absolutely love. As with the last couple videos, if you want to grab the exact wavetables and noise files to follow along with this video, there's a link in the description down below for a free download of my organic wavetable and noise bundle. As for the preset itself, that's included with all my other tutorial presets in every pack over at synthhacker.com. So we're going to start by creating our custom wavetable in the editor, but if you want to skip this step, the wavetable from the free bundle I used for both oscillators was SH Mallet 03. To start with, we're going to type in a pitch value of C3 and then drag our mallet sample into the wavetable editor. We're then going to cycle through the wavetable using an LFO in envelope mode at a low rate of 1.2 Hz. What's great about this sample was that it didn't require any cleaning up in the wavetable editor. If you're using your own custom mallet sample and it sounds a little distorted, I'd recommend checking out my recent video on custom wavetable tricks and tips, which I'll link down below. Next, to add some width and thicken the sound up, we're going to add 7 voices of detuned unison. We're also going to add some upper harmonics to the sound by copying osc A to B, applying the same LFO to the wavetable position and pitching it up an octave. So now we have the basic harmonic structure set up. There are a number of different directions we could go with this sound. For this key sound, I wanted to retain the pluck-like nature while still making sure the sound was present when the keys were held down. To achieve this, I kept the attack short while bringing the sustain down with a little bit of decay and release. You can dial in the attack of the sound to your own personal taste, with a slightly longer value giving you a softer, more pad-like sound. Similar to the last video where I covered making a brass stab in Serum, I found that a filter wasn't really necessary for this sound. However, I definitely encourage you to experiment with this yourself. Moving into the effects though, the first module I used was the dimension expander with a low size and relatively high mix amount. Now, one effect I really like on these types of sounds is a subtle amount of downsample distortion, similar to what I used in my future RnB Chords for Serum video. We can apply this by selecting downsample from the distortion list, setting our downsample rate to about 18%, and using a new envelope to modulate the mix amount. As you can hear, using an envelope to modulate the mix amount lets us have much more control over how much of the downsampling we hear and for what duration. I definitely encourage you to play around with modulating the mix amounts of other effects you use, as it's a very simple way to create patches that sound a little bit more dynamic. To thicken up key sounds, one effect I use a lot is chorus. We're going to increase the mix amount while also making sure we keep the low pass filter open to make sure the high end transients of the sound can still pass through. Finally, to polish the sound, I use Serum's internal EQ to control how much high end of the sound there is in relation to the low end. One useful trick I like to use is a macro that attenuates the lower frequencies of the sound while simultaneously boosting the high end using the EQ's shelf mode. In regards to external effects, the only thing I used was a bit of Valhalla Hall reverb with a relatively low mix amount. Obviously, Serum's own reverb is more than capable, but I personally prefer the sound of dedicated reverb plugins. So there we have it, a really versatile mallet-based key sound in Serum. As always, if you want to get your hands on this preset along with all my other tutorial presets, they're included with every pack over at synthhacker.com. And again, if you want to grab just the wavetable and noise files I used for this sound, they're included in my free wavetable bundle at the link in the description below. I definitely recommend checking that out as it's a great way to give yourself some more interesting starting points for your own sounds, rather than just using the same old wavetables everyone else uses. I've got some more great videos in the works I'm excited to share with you, so be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and click the notification bell. I'd also love for you to come follow me on Instagram, for which my handle is simply just @SynthHacker. That's all from me though, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.